so fighting a bit. And Hassam Ndam Njikan from Cameroon with much love via Paris and via several other parts of the globe. It's Bill Montes, it's Jean, it's Box Nation. Enjoy it. See you in a minute or so.
Jerry Belmonte. Son adversaire dans le point rouge, his opponent in the red corner. Official weight, a solid 135 pounds. Wearing red, trimmed with white. His professional record, an excellent one. 28 wins with only one defeat, with 20 wins coming by way of knockout. He is the current NABF lightweight champion, the Moya Jerry Njong. Your referee, Michael Griffin.
You gentlemen, receive my instructions. Protect yourselves and obey my commands at all times. I want you to touch gloves now, men. Your box at the bell. God bless you both.
Let's see how these lightweights match up. Belmontes is 7 years younger. However, he is 1.5 inches taller, but Jerry Jean has a slight reach advantage.
And we're getting ready to go. Jerry Jean, the Montreal fighter, was born in Haiti. He's wearing the red trunks with white trim. Belmontes, black gloves, silver with red trim.
I'm actually surprised that Belmontes is the taller fighter. He's somebody who was a prospect at junior featherweight. So he's coming up in weight. Jerry Jean has come down in weight all the way from welterweight. But he is a compact little guy, Jerry Jean. Just muscle on muscle on muscle.
You say he's one big muscle, one big kinetic muscle?
Yes, one big quick twitch muscle. And he's known for his explosiveness, the speed and the power. We'll see if coming down 5 pounds, if that's added to it or taken away from it. Be interesting to see if this fight gets into the later stages, depending on the pace, if fighting at the lighter weight, if it sort of takes away from Jerry Jean, or if he feels great fighting at lightweight.
What a concept. You get older and you lose weight. That's what Jerry Jean's doing. With Jerry Belmonte is a young fighter at the age of 26, but he's had some battles and some wars over the years. He's 19-6 with 5 KOs. Not a big puncher, but he's in there and he'll mix it up with you.
And you see he's very poised, he's always calm, doesn't look like anything ever ruffles his feathers. And that probably speaks to his amateur background. He has a more extensive amateur career than Jerry Jean did. And he's the crafty guy in here. He's maybe the technician of the two, whereas Jean, it's quite obvious. He has the athleticism, he has the speed and the power. And I have to imagine he's rehydrated more than Belmontes, a natural featherweight.
Jean has won his last three after that loss to Lamont Peterson. Belmontes is 1-5 in his last six. He beat Will Thomason, then he lost to Andrew Cancio, lost to Francisco Vargas, lost to Omar Figueroa, lost to Abner Cotto and Miguel Vasquez. But all of those by a decision. He's never been stopped.
Those are all solid fighters. All those guys are really, really good. He hasn't faced chumps, and I think,
and he, that's what he wants.
Yeah, interspersed in those losses, he's had some decent wins. I know he got an upset decision victory over Will Tomlinson from Australia, and Tomlinson was the favorite going into that matchup.
That was the first time Tomlinson had ever been to the United States, and that got Belmontes back into the mix. He started his career 17-0. He's 2-6 since then. Jerry Jean. Perfect, undefeated in Canada, including 4-0 here at the Bell Center.
When Belmontes was up against the ropes, Jean got a right hand in, but Belmontes slipped the next two punches. He's a savvy guy. Highlights from that opening round. Jean fainting, jabbing to the body, trying to come over the top. He lands some punches, but Belmontes does a good job of smothering him on the inside. And here you see when Belmontes was up against the ropes, he kind of rolled with the right hand and then evaded a follow-up hook from Jerry Jean. So Belmonte showing some of his defensive slipperiness. And this is Mike Mofa in the corner, Gary Jean. He opened up a gym here in Montreal that has taken a lot of kids off the street and turned their lives around. A lot of folks, a lot of Haitian immigrants like Gary Jean, have used boxing to kind of get their lives together.
Second round scheduled for 12, lightweight division. Gary Jean, who didn't start boxing until he was 18 years old, against Jerry Belmontes. What an extensive amateur career.
A lot of speed in this fight. Usually, Jean is the faster fighter, but facing a guy who was a former featherweight, he's kind of bringing that speed up with him. Quick hands from both fighters.
Good right hand from Gary Jean. Body work from Jean. Measuring up Belmontes, who's covering up. Gets off the rope, throws a couple of jabs.
Power edge definitely to Jean. You can just hear the difference in their punches.
Body work from Belmontes. You see the difference in speeds also.
Well, Jean is the more explosive of the two. But Belmontes has some quickness. Maybe it's a sneaky quickness.
Halfway through the second round. Scheduled for 10. Good left from Jean. Here's Jean starting to load up on his punches here in the second round.
I can tell Belmontes has got his eye on him, and he's looking to try to time him in between those shots.
Jean just so quick with that jab. Minute to go in the second round. Good right from Gary Jean. Tags Belmontes, latches with the right and a left of his own.
That was a nice move from Belmontes. Not a lot of power on it, of course, but good scoring blows. Right hand, then a pivot, then a left hook.
Gary Jean, the Haitian fighter, was born in Haiti. When he was 10, then he moved to Canada. Good right from Jean, followed an uppercut. In the corner is Belmontes, trying to get off those ropes and mix it in with Gary Jean. A big right from Jean, and Belmontes' glove touches the ground. He's going to get ruled a knockdown.
Yeah, that's a technical knockdown if one of the fighter's gloves touch at the end of a punch. And a punch definitely landed. It was a nice, big overhand right. Jean measuring Belmontes for big overhands right. Lands left of the body. 1-2 down the middle. And here he is backing Belmontes up to the ropes. Landing hooks and overhand rights. The overhand rights connected to the ear. This is a nice bird's eye view of that knockdown. Right over the top. Right over Belmontes' left hand. Belmontes still standing right here, but he's a little bit shaken up. Gary Jean smells blood, comes in with a follow-up right hook that makes Belmontes touch canvas with his glove.
Third round, Gary Jean landed some heavy shots, sending Belmontes to the canvas in the second round. The last three fights for Gary Jean, he's KO'd his opponent. Most recently, in March, he knocked out Carlos Manuel Reyes right here at the Bell Center. That was a fight that went three rounds. Good combination from Jean. Belmonte is a fighter. He's hit the deck before in his career. He's faced adversity.
He didn't seem hurt by that knockdown in the previous round.
It was ruled a knockdown because his glove touched. He didn't, body didn't hit the ground.
His eyes looked good. He didn't seem wobbly going back to his corner. And, you know, he's had that break, that 1 minute break to recover.
He looked into his corner and he gets tagged. What's Belmonte's doing?
Sometimes Belmonte is just a little bit too calmed in there. I don't want to even call it poise. Sometimes he gets lackadaisical.
Keep your hands up, pay attention, keep your opponent in front of you. Especially one like Jean who's starting to land some of the bigger shots.
He definitely needs to keep his back off the ropes. He needs to try to prevent Jean from walking him backwards. Should keep kind of walking around Jean. He's able to nail Jean when he gets off from an angle.
Like that?
Yes, but when he's right in front of him, he does a lot of covering up.
Body shot from Belmonte is countered by Jean. A good right. Good 1-2 from Jean.
Jean is definitely looking for that right hand. Now, he landed it at the end of round two by looping it. He's trying to get around that guard, so he's looping it to the body now when Belmonte goes against the ropes. Tried to split the guard with an uppercut there.
Quick right hook from Jean. Belmonte's covering up. A lot of those big shots hitting the leather. A little bit of a redness over the left eye of Jerry Belmontes. Good right from Jean.
And that's the reason that eye's getting red. Jean is finding a home for his right hand.
Those of you saw the fight against Lamont Peterson and there is Jean. It was a fight where he was fighting outside of Canada for the first time. Looked a bit nervous. And going up against Lamont Peterson is going to be tough anyway, especially in Washington, D.C.
Started out well, and Peterson made adjustments, and he wasn't able to adjust to Peterson's adjustments. And once, a nice overhand right from Belmontes. He needs to follow up with that, though. But once Peterson got into his rhythm and really started putting some pressure on Jean, Jean just let the veteran take over. Not a bad round from Belmontes, but not enough to win it. He's able to pick off a lot of those shots with that high guard, but he's not throwing enough leather back to even threaten to win a round. This is Hassan Indom practicing on the mitts, practicing that 1-2 of his. That's his money punch combination.
We got a good lather going out.
And warmed up.
Hey.
At least for the time being, it looks like Belmontes has sort of taken the jab away from Jean just by beating him to it, although it looks like Jean's trying to get it back.
Here, Jean came out really quick the first couple of rounds. Coming down in weight at the age of 33.
That's usually not a good thing when somebody's in his early 30s to make that decision to come down in weight, but...
It affects your power, doesn't it?
Well, yeah, sometimes it affects a fighter's stamina. And maybe he feels bigger and stronger than his lighter opponents in the early rounds, but as the fight wears on, depending on the pace, sometimes he loses gas a lot quicker than when he was at the heavier weights.
Well, he's the 1% of the humans that can go down in weight when they're in the 30s. Everybody's usually going up.
I don't know where he's getting the pounds. I mean, he's not a tall guy. He's 5'6" and a half. and he looked just as ripped as he is now when he was at 140 and even at 147.
Finding out at that heavyweight. There is Jean working the body. Montreal fighter as Belmontes goes low, and that is going to get stopped. It didn't look to be intentional, but it really caught there is Jean on the cup.
Belmontes knew he fouled him as soon as it happened. Let's watch a replay. Right hand. Yeah. He was trying to load up with a left of the body, and Jean had his right hand on top of Belmontes' head. Or actually, his left hand on top of Belmontes' head. He'll get 5 minutes to recover.
Yeah,
he needs that much.
You get 5 minutes to recover, and you can take as much as you want of that. And then whenever you feel ready, you can come back, right?
Exactly. And if you're not ready to come back after 5 minutes, well, then you forfeit.
Jean with a left hook to the body. In the corner is Belmontes. He's been getting caught in that corner. Jean's really been doing good work when Belmontes is back on the ropes. 10 seconds to go in the round. Yuri Jean. Jerry Belmontes in Montreal.
Restez allumé devant lui, man, au début de la ronde. Restez allumé, bougez la tête. Avec ses mains hautes, man. Donc, ça va trop bien, man. Ça va trop bien, Bougie. Come on, man. You're looking good. OK, ne trop pas reculer. Reste pas dans le corps.
Fifth round between Yuri Jean and Jerry Belmontes. From the lightweight division. Good left from Yuri Jean. Jean's been able to land his punches with ease. A good right hand. As now Belmontes is trying to trade with him.
I think Jean is at his best when he's putting his punches together, when he's throwing twos and threes in succession.
He's starting that here in the fifth round. We're scheduled for 10 from the Bell Center in Montreal, Canada. Bethel Duran along with Doug Fisher. Jean is eluding punches. The speed from Yuri Jean is really a difference here.
I think the speed and the power. And with the exception for the with the previous round, oh, that was a nice stiff jab from Belmontes. Snapped the head back of Jean. But with the exception of the fourth round, I think Jean has outworked Belmontes. I thought round four was a decent round for Belmontes.
Belmontes came in stronger.
You can make an argument for him winning that round. It was competitive. It was close. I don't know if he's going to get it on the official scorecards, but he needs more rounds like that.
Jean's good right hand set up by that jab.
Belmontes is not going to get him if he's waiting on Jean.
Well, Jerry Belmontes can take some punches.
He's tough. He partially blocked some. If you saw what he did right there with that right cross, he twists his head. So he turns with the punch, but some of the punches land, and he takes them because he's tough.
He's not a fighter that's going to shy away from you. He's going to stand there, eat some leather, as he's doing right now, as Jean is just landing with ease. And Belmontes lands a couple of his own.
See, a nice, crisp hook from Belmontes in spots, but
that's always been his style in his career for Jerry Belmontes. To his own detriment.
Right. I mean, that was the argument against him in the Omar Figueroa fight, is that Omar Figueroa was the aggressor and the busier fighter.
45 seconds to go in the fifth round. Uppercut from Jean, the Haitian fighter from Montreal. Landed. He's been looking for that one all night. Able to finally land it flush.
It was
overhand right from Jean.
It was flashy, that uppercut, but I actually think that Belmonte's turned a little bit with it. We might see it in the replay, but
that one landed.
I like that Jean is committing to his punches. I mean, he's not holding back at all.
Strong right from Jean. Belmonte's countered with one of his own. 10 seconds to go in a good round between Jean and Belmonte's in Montreal.
And Team Indom saying some prayers before he takes center stage. They're a very tight-knit team. Everybody with Hassan Indom fights vehemently for him. Then he goes in the ring and he fights for himself.
And he did a Paris on the back of his team's tracksuit. He lives in Paris, France, originally from Cameroon.
See some highlights from round 5. Best score from Jean. Jean letting both hands go. Straight jabs, followed up by right crosses, followed up by uppercuts. And a nice lead right hand landed by Jean as he backed up. But Belmonte's landed his right and a grazing left hook before Jean tied him up.
Quick way. Get back, back. Avance avec le jab. Avance avec le jab avec les points qui. Reste pas les dessus.
Gary John in the red with white trim. Jerry Belmonte is silver and red. 6 rounds scheduled for 10 in the lightweight division. Belmonte's glove hit the canvas in the seconds it was ruled the knockdown. Gary John's controlled this fight from the opening bell.
Belmonte has had moments. He had moments in round 4. He had moments in round 5. Enough to win the rounds? No, I don't think so.
That's a good left. Jean gets away.
And he's doing enough to make Jean think in there. He's not really a physical threat to the local fighter, but he's not easy.
Good right from Belmontes.
It's not like Jean doesn't have any moment where he can just sort of take over and try to overwhelm him. That hasn't happened yet. He's definitely had the stronger moments than Belmonte's has.
Belmonte's doing a good job of covering up. Jean loading up on those punches. They're hitting leather. The Bell Center in Montreal, Canada, opened up in 1996. Home of the Canadians. Montreal, a good fight city.
It's hosted a lot of championship boxing over the years.
Gary Jean, a fighter now living in Montreal.
And they're just kind of going tit for tat here, you know, covering up and throwing lead right hands. To be honest, I expect a little bit more from Gary Jean. He's Ring Magazine's number 7 rated lightweight. This is a division that has possibilities, and he's a... He can be a very exciting fighter because of that speed and power and his athleticism, but seems to be holding back right here. Now he's finally letting his hands go, touching the body of Belmonte's.
Belmonte's warned for another low blow.
If Gary Jean wins and looks impressive here tonight, you know, he becomes a possible opponent, maybe for some of the lightweight title holders. Golden Boy Promotions, which is a co-promoter of this bout, they have a really good lightweight title holder from Venezuela named Jorge Linares. That would be an excellent matchup, Linares and Jean, because of their athleticism and their skill.
Linares from Venezuela, but lives in Tokyo, Japan.
And he speaks Japanese.
An exciting fighter. Good nice. Right hand from Jean.
Nice right hand.
Good round for there is Jean in the 6. Jerry Belmontes.
Gary Jean loading up with his right to the body and then the head, and then landing a clean left hook. Belmontes answering to the body. Quarterline shots. Nice jab from Jean. Sets up his right hand, but he misses with a follow-up hook. Belmontes takes a right to the ear. Left to the chest, another right to the ear. Finished round six strongly.
Gary Jean, Jerry Belmontes. Seventh round scheduled for 10 in that lightweight division. And Doug, you were mentioning the people that are so talented in that lightweight division. You mentioned a Golden Boy fighter, Jorge Linares. Who are some of the other names?
There's Mickey Bay. He has the IBF strap. Linares has the WBC strap. Mickey Bay, also a very good boxer. Lots of athleticism, lots of skill and technique. Athleticism almost on par with Jean, but probably a better ring general than Gary Jean is. Jean is dynamic in spots, and then there's these lulls that are kind of inexplicable. Because it's not like Belmontes is a physical threat to him. As I've mentioned before, Belmontes is a guy who began his pro career at 122 pounds. They're now fighting at 135 pounds. And I have to imagine that Jean has put on some weight since yesterday's weigh-in. I mean, he's probably like a welterweight right now.
The rehydration, he came in right at the lightweight limit. Right on the dot. You mentioned the names in the lightweight division, Linares, Mickey Bay. Gary Jean was controlling this fight early on. Now he just seems like he's in cruise control. Left, right, body. Good work from the Montreal fighter. Belmontes, the tough Texan, isn't going anywhere. Stands there, eats it.
You see what I'm saying? Gary Jean just had that moment where he put hands on Belmontes, landed most of the shots. Belmontes kind of blocked and turned with some, but then
that
Jean, yeah, he takes his foot off the gas pedal. And Belmontes, if he feels like it, he throws a few punches back.
Just like he did there with that jab.
And those punches, in return, they don't hurt Jean. But it's just kind of, it kind of befuddles me. Now, the bigger, stronger, faster, more athletic fighter isn't imposing himself physically more on the naturally smaller guy.
We've seen that Belmontes can take a punch. Oh, just like that. He shakes his head. No, yeah, you did. He got tagged.
Now, don't admire your work, Jean.
That's a slip. Referee Michael Griffin says it's a slip. But Jean did admire that big shot that Belmontes took.
Now, maybe Belmontes' chin discourages him, but I think I want to see more from Jean.
Jean continues to go upstairs, but we see.
I don't know if you can tell. I don't know. Does Jean look a little bit tired to you, Beto?
He's breathing a little heavy.
It hasn't been like a torrid pace so far.
But he has been loading up on some of those punches. So has to take a little bit afterward.
He's loaded up and he's missed with some big punches, and that can take a lot out of a fighter. Good crowd filling in here at the Bell Center.
Yeah. Eighth round, we're scheduled for 10. Yuri Jean, Jerry Belmonte. Jean in control of this fight from the opening bell.
If you ask me, I would say that Jean has an insurmountable lead on the scorecards. Certainly does on my very unofficial scorecard, but I'm sure that's the case with the official judges. So the question is, does he coast for these final three rounds, or does he try to make a statement? And we will see.
Last three fights for Yuri Jean have ended in a knockout. Jerry Belmonte has never been stopped.
And that is in part because of his caginess, but not in part, and just he's just a tough little dude.
He takes a tough,
he's got a chin.
It's not like he's a fighter who's slipping and going away and you can't catch him. He's right there for you. He's going to mix it up with you.
I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that Jean is holding back a little bit with his punch output because he's maybe just concerned about his stamina at lightweight, going the 10-round distance at lightweight. Maybe he feels something where he doesn't feel as strong as perhaps he would have going 10 rounds at 140 pounds.
Do you see that?
I could be totally wrong. I could be totally wrong, but and to me, it looks like he's purposely holding back just a little bit.
Like he's not pouring it on, like which he could. He's picking his spots. He's definitely slowed down for the first four rounds.
It seems to me that Jones holding back just enough, and Belmontes is glad of that fact. Now, Belmontes is not going to take advantage of the fact that he's in with the guy who's you know, not punching for 3 minutes of the round. And Jean is content to sort of set the pace and slow the pace up a little bit.
So you have two fighters that are content with what's going on?
Right. So we kind of get a little bit more intense than your average sparring session, but not much so.
Well, the crowd's not content.
Yeah, you can tell they're not into it.
Belmonte takes a punch, shakes his head, no.
The fight, it's watchable. It's not a total, it's not a sneaky fight, but there's some intensity that's lacking.
Berman has a little smirk on his face. Lands a left. He's on his toes. 10 seconds to go in the eighth round. We're scheduled for 10.
That was a nice little shot that Belmontes landed at the end of round eight. And I can see it just slightly in the body of Jean. He is tired.
A lot of that with the weight, huh, you think?
I think so. I think it's fighting at lightweight is tough for him. As Hassan Ndam composes himself in deep fighter meditation, showtime is almost here for him.
Ninth round, there is Jean in the red and white. Jerry Belmontes, the silver and red. Belmontes from a fighting family. His father, Sal, was 3-1 as a pro. His brother, Steve, is also a pro fighter, a younger brother.
And Sal is in his corner as a cut man and an assistant trainer, keeping him relaxed in between rounds. I'd love to see a little bit more motivation from him, but I think in part, he's happy to be able to go rounds with a guy like Jean.
And Jerry Belmonte has never had a problem going rounds. But when do you get satisfied just going rounds with somebody if he gets tagged with a big right from Jean? Maybe that second wind is kicking in for the Haitian fighter, now living in Montreal.
I'd like to see him close the show by fighting this ninth round hard. And really, whatever he has in his tank in the final round, if we get there, I'd like to see him empty that tank. I'd like to see him do something that makes the fans here in the Bell Center get up off their seats.
Lamont is keeping his hands down here in the ninth round. Body work from Jean. Really the first time we've seen this tonight where he's going to the body. Lamont is backpedaling. Gary Jean, Jerry Belmontes, ninth round, the lightweight division.
We're seeing more lateral movement from Belmontes than fist movement. I don't know if he's settled into survival mode, if he just wants to go the 10-round distance.
Loading up is Jean, but he misses, gets hit with the right.
Yeah, that overhand right was a punch that worked for him in earlier rounds. Maybe he can find a home for it here in the late rounds. I think he can if he can pin Belmontes to the ropes. But if you notice, Jean just kind of follows Belmontes around the ring. He doesn't cut the ring off.
Landed a couple good lands. Belmontes hit. Lances with the left of his own. Now they're trading finally.
This is what the fans want to see.
In the corner, Belmontes keeping his hands down. Jean is trying to tee off.
And that smashing overhand right when it lands to the ear high on the temple, it rocks the equilibrium of Belmontes.
10 seconds to go in the round. Jean, wild swing and miss. Another swing and a miss. Belmontes right there in the mix.
Leaving his hands down, kind of daring Jean to tee off.
I wish you would.
Good stuff. All right, end of the round action. It was good stuff. Got a rouse out of the crowd. Overhand left, landed on the temple. Belmontes tried to say it landed in the back of the head, but whatever. It made his legs wobble a little bit as he slides against the ropes. The smashing short overhand right, followed by another smashing overhand right. And that one did land sort of to the back of the ear. A left hook landed from Belmontes. He misses with the right. And finally, we're seeing Gary Jean empty his tank, let his hands go. Good stuff at the end of round nine.
Two fighters in the middle of the ring, touch gloves, give each other a hug, and we get going for the last round. Jerry Belmontes' glove touched the canvas in the second that was ruled a knockdown. And Gary Jean has controlled this fight. Gary Jean, 33 years old. He's 28-1. Jerry, the Corpus Christi kid, Belmontes, 26 years old, 19-6. There's been a fight where Gary Jean took a couple rounds off, but he came back in the ninth, swinging wild in the corner. And Belmontes, you said, it had his gloves down, said, "I dare you."
Yeah, he wasn't even attempting to cover up at the end of round nine.
He's covering up in the 10th.
Gary Jean is trying to put some mustard behind these punches. Definitely doesn't look like he's going for a final round knockout or knockdown. If it comes, it comes, but I don't think he's going to try to force the issue. And it's kind of one of those fights where I'm sure on the scorecards, very one-sided. I wouldn't be surprised if...
Shutout.
If Jean wins by shutout on at least one of the scorecards. Maybe you could score, maybe round four could have gone to Belmontes. He had a pretty decent round. He had a decent round five. But not letting his hands go enough. He could find a home for his left hook occasionally, but just wasn't cranking it enough.
Where does Jean go from here?
Well, you know, he's a ranked fighter. I think if they want to move him up the rankings, he has to beat somebody who is ranked, and obviously Jerry Belmontes is not ranked in anyone's top 10. So he needs to look for somebody, maybe a former title holder, maybe somebody like Miguel Vasquez, which would be a that would be tricky. If he thinks Belmontes is tricky, somebody like Miguel Vasquez is very cagey and also tall and rangy, but somebody who is, rated in the top 10 of one of the four major sanctioning bodies, maybe in, like I said, a veteran, but somebody who's known, somebody who still has some respect, though.
Thirty seconds to go in the fight. Here, Jean has controlled it the entire time. It was a clash of heads. It's a clash, no blood. 20 seconds to go in the fight.
That left eye still squinting from Jerry Belmontes.
Yeah, it was tagged early and often. And then you see some blood underneath the left eye of Jean in that clash of heads. The final seconds of the fight between Jean and Belmontes. And that'll do it. Thierry Jean and Jerry Belmontes go the distance in Montreal, Canada. A fight that Thierry Jean, all in, as they call him, control from the opening bell. Coming up, the decision from the Bell Center between Jean and Belmontes. There you see the action between Belmontes and Jean. This was early on in the fight, middle
first
round
action. Strapping. And Jean came out strong, throwing combinations to the body and the head. He was able to score a technical knockdown with an overhand right to the ear when Belmontes' glove touched canvas. That was round two. And whenever Belmontes' back touched the ropes, that was when Jean was really able to impose that greater weight and power and physical strength on the smaller but craftier fighter. One thing Belmontes proved, which he's proved in all of his fights, is he hasn't had any easy touches in his career. He could take a shot. You see, he turns with a lot of punches, he twists, he'll partially block punches, shoulder roll, but when he gets hit flush, he takes the shot, and he does fire back, as you see with his back against the ropes. He's got some machismo here. This is at the end of round nine. And there were spots in round nine and round 10 that really got the crowd into it. Not a great action fight, but definitely a watchable fight and definitely a solid outing for Thierry Jean.
Thierry Jean, the Haitian fighter now living in Montreal.
Doesn't have a huge following in Montreal like David Lemieux or like Jean Pascal or Adonis Stevenson, but he's slowly building it. He's been rebuilding his career since that one loss against Lamont Peterson, and he's on his way.
And there you see, there he's Jean. Jerry Belmontes, they go the distance. Coming up, the official judges' scorecards. Jerry Jean didn't start boxing until he was 18 years old, making up for lost time. Only one loss on his career. That was a tough fight against Lamont Peterson, as we mentioned it earlier, but that was for a title. Of the United States, but here at home in Montreal, fish at the Bell Center. That's his home.
But they can target a contender. Oh, I think that's former light heavyweight champ in the red shirt, Jean Pascal, looking like a rock star.
Pascal, Bernard, and Oscar. Selfie, 2015. Ain't nothing wrong with taking that selfie. Got to get the picture right.
Alors, mesdames, mesdemoiselles, messieurs, après 10 rounds d'action, nous nous dirigeons vers les cartes de pointage. Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 hard-fought rounds, we go to the scorecards. Judge Carusone has it, 99-90. Judge Esno, 99-89. And Judge Woodburn has it, 98-91 for your winner by unanimous decision. And still, NABF lightweight champion, J.D. Allinjohn.
Yes, Allinjohn there, a highly ranked lightweight. Sometimes frustrating watching him, Rich. You think there's more, then he shows you the burst to show you that there is more. And then he sort of plays it safe or goes into his shell. I don't know what it
is. Yeah, he started the contest really quick, I thought. I thought he started very well indeed and going into the middle rounds. I think he probably put a little bit too much into the contest early on, thinking he was going to stop the guy.
So
some guys you don't stop. And-